This is the era when all of the promises of the Civil War are going to start falling apart. After the Civil War, we get the 13th, 14th, and 15th Amendments. And those are all civil rights amendments. The 13th abolishes slavery. The 15th gives black men the right to vote. But the 14th Amendment grants all civil rights to all persons.
On July 9, 1868, just 3 weeks before the Burlingame Treaty was concluded, the 14th Amendment to the United States Constitution was formally adopted. Despite bitter opposition from most states of the fallen Confederacy, which were forced to ratify it to regain representation in Congress. Overruling the Supreme Court's decision in Dred Scott, which had denied citizenship and all civil rights to black Americans, the 14th Amendment's Citizenship Clause declared that all persons born or naturalized in the United States are citizens of the United States, who cannot be deprived of life, liberty, due process, civil rights, or equal protection under the law. In the decades to come, the spare 80-word text would form a last slender line of defense for the Chinese in America, as the country began a long, slow descent into an abyss of hatred and violence directed against all people of color.
February 6th, 1869, Chicago. We warn working men that a new and dangerous foe looms up in the far west. Already our brothers of the Pacific have to meet it. And just as soon as the Pacific Railroad is completed, these Chinamen will begin to swarm through the Rocky Mountains like devouring locusts and spread out over the country this side. Men who can work for a dollar a day are a dangerous element in our country. We must not sleep until the foe is upon us, but commence to fight him now. In the name of the working men of our common country, we demand that our government forbid another Chinaman to set foot upon our shores. The Workingman's Advocate.